There's a saying that if you get simple beauty and nothing else, you get the best thing God created. I like that saying. That's why I grow flowers. I decided I wanted to create a garden with yellow, orange and red zinnias. I didn't want blue and purple in my garden. I only wanted yellow, orange and red. I used these things that you get from a loaf of bread to identify the colors that I wanted to pick seeds from in winter. And that's why I kept on keeping these little white tickets. And now we'll go and see what I have managed to create in 7 or 8 years. Those are my yellow, orange and red zinnias that has taken me 8 years to produce from what you first saw. I started with a mixed packet of seeds. I've culled all the purple and blue out of the equation. I'm now basically left with yellow, orange and red. And I hope you like what you see. I had an idea that I'd have a border of orange and yellow nasturtiums. Yellow, orange and red being the theme of my zinnias, I wanted to include that in my nasturtiums. And they've been very obliging this year. They've actually done exactly what I wanted them to do with the orange and yellow. But it's been a fantastic year for a garden this year. It's absolutely magnificent year. Stagger my plantings. Those are my first zinnias planted in September. 2 weeks later I planted those over there. And then another 2 weeks later I planted these here. These here. Not the small ones. These here. And then about 6 weeks later I pulled the Californian poppies out and planted these small zinnias which you're looking at now. And these zinnias are imported in a packet from Australia. Such gardens are not made by saying, oh, how beautiful and sitting in the shade. And to keep these flowers going, we have to water them in the morning and in the afternoon every single day from September until April. Twice a day for 7 months or 8 months. Otherwise, because they planted in such a density, they consume a huge amount of water and they have to be constantly watered. So to get this effect, you've got to spend a great deal of time in your garden. If you miss 2 days, you can kiss your garden goodbye. Man, I saw these yellow flowers. And I stopped my car and I said, Ruth, do me a favor, get out and steal a few for me, please. And Ruth, being a very honest person, didn't want to do what I was asking her to do. But I said, please Ruth, I begged her and she did. And so what you're actually looking at are stolen flowers. They belong in someone else's garden. And there's a bit of the mongrel in all of us. Some of the birds found in our area are the little blue waxbill, known as the bluey, the red firefinch, and the stunningly beautiful crimson-breasted shrike. Thank you. It's called the Great Wall of Africa.
And all the stack there, no cement? No?
Just there.
Yeah.
That's not cement, I suppose that's old-fashioned dugger and clay.
Yeah.
Clay and cement maybe, not proper cement. But it was done by ox wagon. Now, these rocks had to be moved manually. Mm. The name of my absolutely stunning home is the Paradise Hotel. Beyond those mountains in the distance lie the white cliffs of Dover. I am just the luckiest little bugger in the whole wide world to be living in Africa. God bless Africa.